are taking a look at the Ag Barometer now with Fred Seaman of CME Group. Welcome back to the show. Good to have you here.
Thanks for having me, Angie. Appreciate it.
So harvest time. I know a lot of farmers and producers out there are checking the numbers. How's it going?
It's been good news and bad news.
Okay.
And especially with the barometer, you know, that we had a little bit of improvement with October. It was mainly on future expectations, and prices didn't do a whole lot. So those expectations appear to be related to farmers thinking costs are going to be under control, I think.
Well, I'm glad you mentioned that, because earlier in the show, we were talking about Tyson Foods, which is increasing its bottom line because those feed costs are coming down.
Mm-hmm.
So what's the expectation there?
Yeah, and that's exactly what we saw during October. Corn and wheat prices didn't really do anything, but we saw actually growth in livestock prices.
Ah.
You know, cattle, hogs, and even soybeans had a little bit of a rally in October, which might have helped those future expectations of the farmers and ranchers.
So farmers and ranchers are feeling good about that. Anything that's been a trouble spot, perhaps?
Well, prices, you know, maybe a little bit of strength in soybeans particularly. Might have sounded pretty good, but prices are still low. So that's one of the concerns. And one of the things I found interesting in this report is the amount of farmers that think prices are going to rally has decreased, but also the number of farmers who think prices are going to fall has decreased. So most everyone thinks we're kind of right where we're going to be.
Oh, interesting. So taking an overall look at the Ag Barometer, how are we doing this year?
Well, again, those future expectations, this is still a very high number, 137, I think, and it's the third highest.
Mm-hmm.
So farmers and ranchers are still optimistic overall.
Are they talking about trade issues anymore?
Trade issues are certainly, I think, one of the underlying concerns of the market. But it's amazing that volatility is as low as it is. So the market, at least, doesn't appear to be pricing in any trade concerns at this point.
Thank you so much for the update, and we look forward to seeing you next month.
Thank you.